Hello everyone, we are into EOS.io Swiss Workshop specially done on EOS today. Just after July 17 UTC, we had the second trial election on Eden on EOS. We have Amy Hines for the first time into an EOS.io Swiss Workshop, so welcome Amy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice being here.
And you are the winner of this 2K EOS prize onto this election. You received this prize, and that's mean a lot because you are here since such a long time into this community, and you deserve all the best with your project. So congrats. Very
Thank
congrats.
You.
So we will dive with you in what does it mean, your project? We have also Chris Barnes for a third time now on EOS.io Swiss Workshop. Thank you, Chris, to join.
Thanks for having me, Patrick. Great to be here as always.
And you are the, we will say, the elected representative of this Eden board, delegates or members. We can choose the name. And we have Joshua. Shout out to him, Joshua Seymour, that is also into this board. We have Felix Ruiz. I will speak with them in other interviews just after you to cover their project. So here we will discuss in layman terms, if you can explain that for everyone that want to go into EOS with your project.
So first of all, we're not official elected board. It's just a test run. We're volunteering our time and effort. And of course, I won a big prize and I'm grateful to Dan for doing that. I think it really changed the dynamics of the election, because we have to discuss in a limited time frame of 50 minutes. Four people have to come up with an agreement of who is going to be the elected representative of this group. And this goes on and on in a pyramid. And you meet random people of the community. And when you have real tokens on the line, it changes the people's dynamics. So
absolutely.
It was interesting. My project, my suggestion was to use the funds to pay for me to develop EOS in a Box. EOS in a Box is a mini website package that you can install same way as people install WordPress if they want to have a blog. So WordPress is open source and free, the software, and you can rent a server on Amazon or anywhere else and upload this package of files, and you have a blog, you have a WordPress, and everybody knows that if they go to www.yourname.com, then they can read what you write. I want to do something similar that will enable the current EOS members who are proficient and know how to handle their private keys and public keys and permissions and stuff. I am frustrated as one of these members when I want to invite my father, my mother, my wife,
yeah,
kids, and they don't want to deal with keeping the private key safe, and you have to back up, you have to write on a piece of paper these 12 words, and worry if this gets lost, then you might be locked out of your account forever. So I want to make it easier for people to be familiar with EOS and use EOS. So I found out about this relatively new standard called WebAuthn. It's short for web authentication. WebAuthn integrates security all the way from the modern mobile phone, which has either a fingerprint ID or face ID.
Exactly. Yeah.
And it uses your biometrics. So it recognizes you as the person interacting with the phone. The WebAuthn actually talks to the web server, which is going to have EOS in a Box, the package of the files on it.
Yeah.
And it will interact with the phone and create a key pair, like a private key, which you have to keep safe and secure.
Mm-hmm.
And that is automatically going to be created in the hardware of your phone, and you will not be able to get it. No malicious actor, no hacker will be able to get your private key. It's
exactly
in the phone hardware. And then
mm-hmm.
your phone can talk to the website, and the website talks to the blockchain. So
yeah.
That's That's the idea. So people don't have to worry about that. The complicated part, because there is always a catch if you try to make something so easy and convenient. Mm-hmm. The catch is what happens if your phone is broken or stolen, mm-hmm. and you want to regain access to your account because you have money in the blockchain. In the old world with email and password, you would just click a link that says, I forgot my password. Or mm-hmm. something like that, and it will mm-hmm. send you an email. Mm-hmm. But I don't want to rely on the email system around the world because that is also broken sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
And I want this to be a pure blockchain solution. Mm-hmm. And without even the need to have a piece of paper with 12 words that you forgot where you put it or something like that. On EOS, the framework is ready for solutions like I want to do, because when you create an account, you have two keys. One is your day-to-day, everyday action, and the other is more important and more rarely used. And that is when you want to change the keys. User that controls the owner key, the master key, mm-hmm. is the one who installed this website. So let's say I installed this website on amihaines.com or something like that, wallet.amihaines.com, and I invite my wife and my kids and my parents and my friends, and I tell them, trust me, I will take care of you if your phone breaks or gets stolen. I will not use that maliciously because I know you personally, right? We have a relationship in the real world. So they can use the fingerprint or face ID. And if their phone gets lost, they talk to me and I will change that to their new phone.
Nice pitch. And you did that in layman terms. I appreciate that because, yeah, we can say in another way, maybe for other people that are maybe most nerd. It's clear the private active key of EOS is stored onto the device, and the owner key belonging to this private active key, that is the admin key that allows to change your active key, or if you lost your active key. If you lost your active key, it's because you lost the phone, or maybe that someone has stolen you. So, and we go back to you as a custodian of the keys and come in play the trust. Again, this word that I hate. So this word trust, that's the problem since 2017. There was an article into The Economist stating the problem of the next decade is the trust. We were in 2017 at the beginning of the dawn of EOS. Now we are 2021. We see that totally trustless, totally the solution. And for this reason, we have hidden on EOS this human layer based on trust and small tribes, small groups. And we have seen now that Chris is reliable. What he has stating in the last election, he is reconducting. Yourself, you are here since day one, and you want to succeed for EOS. So we see your intent. So if I have to choose this solution, I will surely choose this solution because I want something very easy to use, to onboard technically. So fantastic, Amy, that you have this system of key recovery. Can you maybe break down a little bit on that? Because that seems so beautiful indeed to be true. So can you maybe break down on that? Thank you.
So the website owner is like the super user or the admin for the people that created accounts on his website. So these are going to be mini websites just for family and friends. It's not a website for, mass population. It's not going to need SEO and be for everyone. You lose the phone or it gets stolen, you come to me if you're one of my family members or friends, close friends. Then I can create a new key pair for you using your phone. And you can continue accessing your account as usual. In the future, I think this can be improved. So even a small group of people, maybe 10 people, don't have to rely on just one family member. This can be expanded. Mm-hmm. EOS is very powerful in that respect, and it can allow more flexibility.
Yeah.
And balance needs to be between simplicity and ease of use. mm-hmm. and power. So if you make it too complicated, people will not use it. So I think mm-hmm. we will need to have a menu of several different options mm-hmm. and make it very easy for people to follow them and exactly. say, okay, we don't want one person, we want three. So it's mm-hmm. me, my father, and my lawyer. I don't know. And any combination like that. And this can also be integrated with the current wallets like Graymas, Anchor wallet, but mm-hmm. in the future, not
in an immediate phase.
It will be very limited. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be open source, so other developers can take a look and see if there are any backdoors or problems and alert me or fix it. Collaborative project.
Okay. About the roadmap, have you in mind some milestones that you have to reach for this project? I don't speak about the dates because the dates is something complicated, but more the milestone where you have to, which milestone you have to reach. You are at the earliest, you have made certainly already some testing for sure, but you have now to develop that, and you will be not alone. You will also give some audit of your code to other developers. So how you see the since now July 24 until the next election, because there is a mandate now, what is your plan?
I hope to be able to make the first working package which will be useful, and people will be able to connect their EOS account, people mm-hmm. that are already on EOS, mm-hmm. and install this on a small website of them, mm-hmm. and then invite their members of the family, and they will be able to create an account using their fingerprint or face ID.
Exactly.
And minimum is to be able to transfer EOS between the accounts, and not just the accounts of the members of the family, because once you have the capability, you can transfer EOS with any account on the mainnet. You're not limited to the group that you belong to create the account.
Exactly, nice. That goes with Circles, mini website. And after that, mm-hmm. later on, the big picture is clear. It's to maybe make that more global, but now we have to go step by step in mini circles, and that's, what is hidden in the Donios? That's the good project for that. Very good project.
What I'm hoping is that this will exponentially grow, because if some people in my family are more proficient in computers than like my kids, then maybe they will make a similar mini website and invite their friends. And you know, if I have 10 friends and family, and some of them create these mini websites, like they graduate, they don't rely on me to be their custodian, but they have an independent account, because this can happen. If I'm the custodian and somebody asks me, okay, I want to be free of your being dependent on your website, I want to have a normal EOS account, we can work together, change the owner key, change the active key.
Yeah, it's just a change of,
And it's their account, and I don't limit them in any way. And then they can also invite their friends and have their mini webs. Anybody who wants to host them can download them and host them. It's like
download and WordPress. Host them.
Anybody can host them. So you're going to have many copies, and the mini website will have a place for you to say what is your name, what is a website, and customize it a little bit. So they don't all look the same.
Okay, so you download this template and you can host it where you want on any provider or host.
Yes.
If you don't have a provider, but let's say you are someone very basic, you go, you download the template, but you don't know where to host that. Have you maybe yourself, you could be a provider or a host for that?
I don't want to do that.
You don't want to do that. Yeah.
I don't want to do that.
That's good. Yeah.
Because it's not something that I'm good at. And I think that on the internet, there are many people that have WordPress blogs on their website.
Yeah.
And some people say, I don't know how to do that. They go to WordPress.com and they pay a few dollars a month and they have their blog on the cloud. But this is different. If
okay.
there are enough people on the web that know how to install a website, let them do
okay.
it.
So I can upload your template on my WordPress website, eosblockchainswitzerland.ch, for example, that is in WordPress. And I can upload this template and I can give an experience to sign transaction from my website using your template indeed.
It's not related to WordPress, but it's similar
no,
to WordPress.
No, but it's so similar, yeah.
If you know how to install a WordPress
yeah.
website, you'll be able to...
Yeah, myself, it. Yeah, but maybe someone else. So we are here to help, it's clear. So you don't take the responsibility to do the provider, the host, but you do the design, the template, and you give this facility for the keys, management of the keys. That's that. Okay, all
think,
that.
Yeah, you said before about trust and how bad it is when we have to trust and that we had a crisis of trust. And I think it started in 2008 when Bitcoin...
Already it did, yeah. Already.
Yeah, so yeah. we moved from trusting completely a
yeah.
few large corporations to
yeah.
not trusting anyone but yourself. Everyone for themselves. And I think we have to be somewhere in the middle. So I'm proposing trusting maybe have 20 people trusting one, maybe something like that.
That's a paradox. That's a paradox, but that's beautiful, the paradox. So we are in Eden for that.
I'm
otherwise.
Feel comfortable.
Yeah.
I don't feel comfortable that more than 20 people will depend on me to manage their accounts. And I will also warn them not to put a huge amount of money on these accounts. And
absolutely. And you are an Eden member, so you have already testified your intent and now you have to deliver. So that's a fantastic experiment. So I have no doubt on your capability and to deliver. That's not the point, but for new members or for new people, they know, Amy Haynes is an Eden member. He was elected, that was a trial election, but that doesn't matter. That was a trial election, but that has to be made seriously and conduct seriously how it that was a real election, but what is real? So now we are in and we are iterate. So that's fantastic. So thank you for this explanation. Very well done. Thank you for that. And I will put all the link into the video description for sure. You have a blog on EOS in a Box blog where you explain, you break down textually for the people that want to read, to see. You have also, I will put the last video of the July 17, the last round where you were in with Chris, with Josh and Felix. Mm-hmm. So perfect. Thank you for that. Now, Chris, I come to you. you are, for the second time, the Satoshi on Eden on EOS, or we can say you are our representative of this Eden on EOS think, and you are participating like today for many Zoom meeting. I will put also the last ones that you made with Brandon Freshner for the next step with the Eden OS operating system for Eden, where we are, and that was July 20. And you were also into a speech with Josh and Felix on the 19, the meetings note just after the, and Amy, just after the last Saturday. And now I want to know a little bit, what is your plan? Because you are a doer, as you say. We want some doers into the EOS ecosystem. And I want to know what is your project? Because you have received also some funds to do a proxy for Eden, and beside this Eden proxy, generally speaking, what you are leading now for the hidden board member.
Sounds good. Yeah, thanks, Patrick. So the Satoshi title has, I think, been retired. I did put a video out on the retirement of the title. People are still using it, and I haven't heard what the replacement's going to be. But like you mentioned, right, ME won the prize, and that was great. And I think he was the right guy to win the prize. I didn't have a use for those 2,000 EOS, so I'm glad he won that. And I'm grateful and humbled that the other three gentlemen chose me to be the symbolic leader of the group, sort of. So, my particular proposal was to start an Eden members approved proxy. So EOS being a delegated proof of stake blockchain means that token holders can basically delegate their tokens, their stake, to block producers to decide who are the miners, if you were to make that equivalent to Bitcoin or Ethereum. So the block producers are basically chosen by token holders via their token stake, how they vote with their tokens and which block producers they choose. So my plan is to create a proxy, which is basically a token holder can choose to delegate their vote to a singular proxy. And that proxy will take the responsibility of reviewing the block producers and selecting what you can select between 1 and 30 block producers to basically represent the voice of those token holders and that are the best block producers to move up the ranks and create the blocks and receive the block pay and the V pay, the voter pay. So it's an important role. I think it's been missing in the EOS community an opportunity to sort of collect and aggregate the small token holders or the whales. But my focus is the regular Joe, right? The regular guys and gals out there who aren't whales, but do have tokens and do care about the EOS ecosystem. So I'm hoping to aggregate, collect those voices, those tokens, and then use a weighting system that selects block producers based on the subjective opinion of Eden members. So this is a unique take. I still want to look at objective metrics. So that is actual hard numbers about block producer performance and what hardware do they have and location, jurisdiction, whether they're missing blocks and latency and anything that's important, which I'm not an expert on. Like, I'm going to rely on people who are far more experienced on this to help me formulate a proper objective set of metrics. But the subjective piece is going to come from the timing was excellent because EOS Costa Rica has put up a tool called EOSRate.io. And this is a tool that allows any EOS account holder to log in and select, they can pick through the BPs, and they have basically five metrics or KPI that they can then subjectively rank each block producer on. And so it's trustiness, so how trustworthy, infrastructure, I don't even remember them all, transparency, there's five of them, yeah. And they all make sense. And so the goal is that I'm going to filter the input from just Eden members. So the thing about Eden is people join Eden because they are willing to, they care that much more about the EOS ecosystem. They're willing to go through a bit of friction to actually join Eden. So I think that speaks to their commitment to EOS, and I want to use their voice to become the subjective voice of this proxy to select the block producers or more heavily weight their choice. So say it's not settled, but say 60 or 75% of how I would rank these BPs will come directly from this subjective point of view. And I will leave the objective metrics, which are still important, but they won't really be what's deciding what this proxy will vote for will be based on the combination of those two perspectives. It's not going to be what I, Chris Barnes, would like to see. The BPs won't be what I prefer. It's what the Eden community prefers. And okay. So I'm going to, any questions?
So you have a project of a proxy and also this scoreboard using EOSRate of Costa Rica with semantic metrics or with quality metrics, not based only on numbers. And do you consider maybe to use some of the scoreboards made by EOS Nation, the BP validation scoreboard, where we see more metrics based on numbers, but yes. it's a combination of both. Maybe you will
That's
use.
Right.
Okay.
I will. Yeah. EOS Nation was part of that. Their scoreboard. Aloha EOS has another one.
Shout out to Matthew Darwin. This is the operation guy behind the EOS Nation 24/7 for the block producer and this scoreboard. Yeah,
yes.
You're right. You have to use reinvent the wheel, but use no. this this force that we have already since 2 years now that is already working. And Costa Rica, EOS Costa Rica, very nice project with EOS rates. That makes totally sense.
And the timing was excellent because I had spoken about in Telegram chat this idea of having an Eden related proxy, and I always mm-hmm. the question was always difficult to answer. How do you choose the block producers, and do you choose it based on whoever the board is at the time? So the final round of Eden delegates, do they get to choose on their subjective views? And that, I didn't like that because we're going to have eventually, when this is official, because as Emmy mentioned at the beginning, this is an unofficial thing, but when it's official, there will be elections every 6 months, and so I think it would be kind of unfortunate to have new people come in and then pick entirely different block producers. There's no consistency there. It moves the goalposts for the block producers themselves to know what they should be doing to have a high ranking within this proxy. So I'd like to keep it somewhat stable. And that way, if it's not based on who's in and out of the Eden delegated leadership, it's just based on, I mean, of course, I'm going to run it. So I guess it's kind of up to me, and we'll see what happens in the future, but ideally hand the keys to someone else. But ideally, I want this to be about the views of the community and not just the views of a few individuals. And I think that's really important and powerful and speaks to the point of Eden, right? Eden is an aggregator of like-minded people in a community who select representatives and delegates based on trust. And so I want to use the wisdom of the crowd of this Eden community to also select block producers.
And the focal point, the trust, as always. And something else that you are working on is to create a framework for Eden on EOS. You are make a precedent, and that's the beginning. And in the absolute, that's a good framework that you are building now with Amy, Felix Ruiz, with Joshua Simo. You are building this framework. Holacracy, I saw that, very interesting. It's not based on a hierarchy of power. It's based on collaborative ecosystem circles. Very interesting. This synergy circle, this emoticon in a form of a cyclic that is used also by EdenOS, Brendan Freshner, this emoticon cycle, cyclic. Because it's a perpetual improvement. We are improving the things. And we cannot do this side a top-down, bottom-up hierarchy. We have circles collaborating between them. So it's clear. I will address that with Josh and Felix. They have also their project. You have other members into the Eden community that have also their project. And at a point, there are some common things or synergies. And with your framework that you are now designing, we have the possibility to fill the holes and say, okay, I have also a proposal. I want to put that here in this, for example, into the marketing or maybe into a particular user onboarding or maybe on education side or on the side of Amy. With the custodian solution for the so you are creating this framework indeed. Can you maybe give some some points on that very short stance on this framework that you are building now? It's in progress, it's just beginning.
So I want Eden to be successful. I mean, this is an overarching goal that I have, right? I want to see Eden successful on EOS to make EOS successful. So that's the plan. And so we're 2 months into this whole Eden experiment. You know, Ami was on the first board with myself and John Heater and Mike Manfredi. And, you know, it was the first time. We didn't know exactly what what mandate do we have? How much authority would you have? We're unofficial, so okay, we shouldn't do a whole lot. And now I'm sort of coming 2 months in, and we've had another election, and I think, you know, unofficial, official is a relative term, because I think we're official in the eyes of the community. Even though we're an unofficial elected delegated membership, that's fine, and we're not changing bylaws, and we're not changing any of the rules, and that's certainly within Dan's and Clarion team's purview. But as it comes to aggregating the community and trying to collect us under and align us in the same direction, that is something we can do. That is within our capacity, even though we're an unofficial mock trial board. So I want to run with that. I want to try to make Eden more efficient and create some sort of framework that isn't dependent on individuals, but is dependent on the community itself. And if we can create a successful framework, like a skeleton, and that we can hand that from elected body to elected body, and they can then use that framework that's pre-established and has some sort of norms and some flow and some function to it, then that will make the transitions easier, and it will create a more functional and effective organization. And again, I think that's really key. We've got a long way to go, but so we're creating a framework that is not built on a hierarchical system where you have, you know, a leader at the top and you're dependent on this individual to make decisions. That's, you know, we don't want dependency on individuals. We want independence of individual, yet dependence on the collective. So we're going to create these larger circles in this holacracy system, where it's a super circle. It just, it's like a, it, so we've defined them in traditional terms that we might recognize, like CMO, but instead of chief marketing officer, it's the chief marketing office. So it's not an individual, it's
not
just
the officer, the office.
It's an office.
Very interesting.
That's right. Yeah. So the whole the whole structure is built around these ideas of an office. And we've got the CFO, Chief Financial Office, a CVO, Chief
Can
Values
you elaborate
Office.
CVO? What does it mean?
CVO is it's more about creating products and services and the values. It can be the values of the organization as well, but how are we creating value? What is the value output?
Chief Value Officer. Office,
that's
value
so,
office.
So for
and
example,
Amy is in the CVO, I think.
He is, because he's creating a product or a service that is going to add value to Eden and EOS. So that's going to, we also have, we're going to project. So one of the issues that has come up is if Eden receives 2.5 million EOS tomorrow, what are we spending it on? We don't have an answer to that question. So that is something that is part of our mandate. We've added that as a goal to attempt to try to help solve that problem. So within each of these offices, we have we've established some goals, and those become sub-circles within a larger circle. And the sub-circles become these sort of goals that we'd like to achieve. And then we have to, so what's next? We haven't done this yet. So we've just created this sort of framework between, and then there's also COO, Chief Operations Office, and CEO, which is the Chief Executive Office, which is less concrete, really. It's more just ideas, but
to make we now a have parallel these, with the current world, indeed.
So it allows, we don't want to be too abstract, so people can't buy in and understand what we're trying to do. So we're trying to create some sort of relationship there. But these are offices, not officers. And in the office, we'll have goals, in sub-circles they're called. And then what we do is we create roles that are within the overarching office, but then roles within these sub-goals. And we want to basically create these holes that people, the community, can then look and say, oh, okay, we need someone who's going to work on comms, someone who likes to deal with interacting with the community, and whatever it might be. We're going to create these sets of roles that then people, the community, can put themselves into. And we're going to have the community fill in these roles, which means it's iterative. So then the next board or the next whatever, they can take these overarching and add different goals and create different roles and allow the community to, again, fill themselves in. And what we'll do, we'll curate it a bit. Like, there is a bit of top down, like we need to be somewhat centralized in the idea that if we're too decentralized, we'll get nothing done. So yes, we're going to slightly try to curate this as as the leadership of Eden currently in this unofficial role. We'll still curate these offices and the respective goals and the roles, and ideally, if this works out, we will create a roadmap for the next couple of months to achieve some of these goals within these super circles.
Okay, so for the audience, I will put all the link into the video description. That's basically going to eoscommunity.org, where you have make a good explanation about your last meeting on July 19, explaining holacracy, this framework, this skeleton, the different offices analogy very well done. So, and you will find also into a new subreddit that is just coming. It's Eden EOS subreddit, and there are already 90,000 members into the Reddit EOS, and we have a link to EOScommunity.org, a link to EdenEOS.org, and we have also a link to an Eden EOS mind map that is getting all this information unified, not centralized, but very unified. And because the information is not centralized, the information is already spreading on different websites, and the mind map is getting all this information together. I love that since a long time. I use that for this reason, to contribute for the community, because we have a lot of information spread everywhere. That's my contribution, and I don't really speak here of my project. That's not the point, but just to say that the mind mapping, this is something that I use frequently. You have also, shout out to Vincent Grenier of EOS Nation. He is also doing some mind maps. This is not lost. This mind map will go onto an online collaborative platform named Mind Web. That's all. I will not unveil all here. So, yeah, there is synergies everywhere. That's collaborative ecosystem on EOS, and Eden on EOS, with this human layer, trust layer, small tribes, small circles. Amy, shout out to you. You deserve this prize. That was randomized at the end.
It's a lot of pressure, you know.
that was randomized at the end, to be clear. That was randomized. That's the goal of the last round, the last round. That was randomized. That could be any other member, but that was you, and I am very proud.
And it was good if any of the other members was elected.
They all deserve. You have all win. You have all win. We have all win during this election.
Randomization.
All the proposals were fantastic, and shout out to Chris to have stated during this round. You will find the link. This is epic. You have to show, guys, for the community that has not the time to watch, show this last round. That's just a fantastic and I unveiled here. Now it's official. So Chris stated during this round, okay, give me your basically give me your trust. I will represent you, continue to do my job, continue to do my things. I cannot agree more of that, because I love this dedication, commitment. So we can speak more, but this is EOSIO Swiss Workshop, and now this is something special. We will have some EOSIO Swiss Workshop special. I announce here, that's my announcement. We will have not only 2 months EOSIO Swiss Workshops, we will have what I named it, EOSIO Swiss Workshop specials. And here it's EOSIO Swiss Workshop special Eden on EOS. There are a lot of specials into the EOS ecosystem, but now we have Eden. We have to communicate that in an effective way. We are different marketing content creator like Felix, others also into the shadow of the EOS ecosystem that are doing a fantastic job. Shout out to Drill Sergeant Zeus, Dario. Shout out to you. You do a fantastic job, man. We are all collaborating as we can, and I try to do my best also. So thank you guys to be with me today, Chris, Amy. Thank you that. And
thank you, Patrick. It was great.
Thank you. You're doing great work, Patrick. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And see you until next time. I have no crystal ball. I cannot say now when that will be, but for sure, this is not the last time. So see you and go EOS.
Go EOS.
Go EOS.